All right, so we... Wait, what are we doing? We're doing the video.
Intrepid.
So today we are going to Intrepid. Normally it would be a bad idea to go on Intrepid during pandemic, but...
Armed with faith.
Tanya claims that the capacity is at 25%. And also me and Tanya already got our first vaccination. So we have some protection, plus we're all wearing face masks. So we'll see how that's gonna go. And hopefully we are going to spend more time outdoors on that platform, because that's what Dennis wants to do.
Yeah, I want to see a bunch of fighter jets.
Yeah, he wants to see fighter jets. I don't think he's interested in old ship equipment indoors. So we're gonna go check it out and try to stay outdoors as much as possible. Are you excited, guys? Okay, Dennis, stop doing that. You're not in the military. Stop doing that. All right. Okay, but we have to go that way. Otherwise, we have to swim to it. All right, we're a little early, so we're gonna just checking it out from the outside. But yeah, there are like all kinds of planes there. The one with the folding wings. That looks like a Blue Angel, but I don't think that is it. I want to see the Black Bird and
me too.
Oh, yeah, Black Bird. I actually read that that's one of the fastest.
Yeah.
I also want to see the Black Bird.
You
want to
see what?
Black Bird.
Is that okay. Where my favorite space shuttle is stored?
Oh, yeah. That I guess that cover is where space shuttle is. I don't know.
Yeah. I really want to see the Black Bird. That's my favorite. That's my favorite fighter jet.
Like a thermos.
So exciting!
Yay! Uh-huh. Right there.
Yay! What's that called?
Yes. Level 1?
Hangar 1.
Yeah.
Okay. It is time to judge.
It's only moving around it.
Woo. Wow, that's a lot of pipes. But that's not very exciting.
Okay.
Let's see. Okay, so this is what they use to help them land. This is for landing. Optical landing system. And that's the propeller that pushes the ship forward. Look how giant that thing is. Propeller. Yeah, and most of them have like folding wings, right? So they fold up, so take up less space.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. They got a cover for it, removed before flight. Yeah, and this is like a weird helicopter deal going on, right? Pikachu. No.
Pikachu.
That's not Pikachu. Dennis, do you know what this pole is for? Do you know what this is for? What does it do? This is to refuel in the air. This is to refuel in mid-air. That's a machine gun right there. That is probably a fuel tank at the bottom, right? That's an extra fuel tank. And this guy is a bomb. That's what they would drop.
Yeah, that is a literal missile right there.
It's not a missile, it's a bomb. It just, they release it and it just goes, bam. It's unlike Tisha. It is unlikely to be guided in any way. This is just a dumb bomb. It just falls straight down. All right, flight deck. Okay, let's see what we got outside here. plan is, check this out.
What?
This is anti-aircraft gun. It's an anti-aircraft. This is what you shoot at the planes that are attacking you.
Yeah, a real gun!
Yeah.
Because we were standing on what was once a real military plane.
I know.
Okay, well, how about this gun, Dennis?
Well, let's see if I can even move.
Okay. I don't think it moves.
Hopefully you should be on it.
Yeah. All right.
There's some damage over here. That's why I was not going.
It's okay.
It's fine.
You can
there.
Go. I'm not sure where you're supposed to stand, but this is where you operate probably. Probably right here is where you operate. Well, I don't know if I would totally go in there, but that's where you aim that giant gun.
Yeah.
What do you think, Dennis? This is pretty cool?
Yeah. I gotta admit, I'm having more fun than I thought.
Okay. And I'm guessing you use these handles to adjust.
And this is like a connecting
things. Well, yeah. And it got a Zerk fitting.
Real Zerk fitting, yeah.
And right outside over there is the fastest passenger jet.
British Airways.
It's a Concorde. That's what it's called. Well, it's right outside.
G-Bold.
Too bad they don't fly anymore. They are too expensive to fly, and all the equipment on them is really outdated. They're all mechanical. They're not computer controlled, or minimum computer controlled. So everything inside is like super ancient. And also the way the engines are, like they would not allow to set up two jet engines like next to each other anymore. It's against all the current rules, because if something happens to one, it like takes out the other one. It's like super dangerous. So it's unfortunately got outdated. Now finally we're coming up on a deck. Okay, don't run, stay with me. All right, now we're gonna get to see all the planes. Andrew and Dennis, stay with me. Look at this angry looking one. Andrew and Dennis, stay with me. So this one looks like it's a Harrier. It's a plane that can take off vertically. Maybe, I'm not sure. We're gonna see. Is this the Harrier? Yeah, it can take off vertically. It doesn't need a runway. That's like really cool plane. See that is?
Yeah.
Harrier. It's really inefficient when it's doing so. It burns up a lot of fuel. So that's why you got this thing right there to refuel it when it gets up in the air.
Yeah.
So it's pretty cool.
Where is our Blackbird?
And this is what? This is Huey. This is a super popular helicopter.
Yeah,
it's called Huey.
Yeah.
There is like a lot of history with those, but I don't really know helicopters much.
Okay, I'm just gonna catch the Blackbird over there.
We are going to make it there slowly, don't worry. And that's like a rescue helicopter. Oh, it can like land on water. Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, with those things, it could just land on water.
Yeah, make
sure. I don't know what this is, but it looks fast.
No.
Oh, it's an Israeli aircraft. And then we got
F-16.
All right, Dennis is really excited about F-16. All right, get some pictures.
Yeah, but this does not look F-16, Fighting Falcon. There's the Thunderbird that Destin went into.
Destin was flying with 16, so that's what he was flying then.
This was the one he was flying, one of these.
Yeah. All right, well, maybe we get to see them during Memorial Show. Do you know what this big thing is on the bottom?
Bomb?
No, that's a fuel tank.
Whoa.
That's so you could go on the long distance. And this one, come back to me. And this is a missile. This is most likely a Sidewinder missile. Don't really know, but they're probably like, they have a little guidance system in the front, and they're looking for infrared. They're looking for heat. So they're locked onto a heat signature of an enemy. This is the plane that Dennis wanted to see. I'll tell you in a minute. Dennis, what is this plane? Oh, it's work in progress. It is a Blackbird. This is the Blackbird plane.
Rocket A-12, don't you
think? I know, but Blackbird is its nickname, not necessarily the official name.
Oh.
So yeah, this is the fastest plane ever.
Yes.
Well, I mean, I think there may be some smaller ones that could go faster now, but this is, practically speaking, this is like
faster than speed of sound.
Speed of sound, yeah.
And 2,300 miles an hour.
And apparently the story that I read, that in the manual, in the owner's manual of the plane, it says, if someone shoots a missile at you, here's what you should do. And instruction says, accelerate. And that's it. Just go faster. Go faster than the missile. Don't worry about it. So yeah, this is a super fast plane. But again, it's super inefficient. It burns a lot of fuel, so it needs refueling as soon as it takes off. That's what I heard. But otherwise, this is a really awesome plane. Okay, Dennis, come this way. Now, this is one of my favorite planes. This is F-14. And again, it's outdated, unfortunately. But it's really cool. It's got folding wings. Not able to carry too much fuel. I believe it can go supersonic, but it needs afterburner. It needs like a fuel injected into the turbines.
The F-16 reminds me. The one at Dresden reminds me. The first
and see, like, you can load, what are these? So these are like Phoenix guided missiles, right? Phoenix, no? Warhead. So these are air to ground. This is what to shoot tanks down with.
Nuclear, are they?
No. So unfortunately, this plane can't carry too many rockets because the wings fold, so it can't hold them at the tips. So again, it's just outdated. And yes, there are two people could sit in it. Yeah, it's been decommissioned. They don't fly them anymore. But whenever you get older, we'll watch Top Gun. That's what they're planes that were flying in there, or one of them, or some of them anyway. That thing that's sticking out, Tanya, you asking. I answered it for every plane we had. That's to refuel it. A lot of these planes, they need to be refueled in mid-flight. That's for the fuel.
What was that thing in the back?
The thing in the back? What thing in the back?
That.
That's just a sensor. That's like a wind speed sensor or air pressure, so one of those sensors. But this one...
Blue Angel.
And this is the Blue Angel, right? This is what the gentleman was telling us, the story. The test pilot of this plane literally shot himself. How did he do that? He fired machine guns. And then he took a dive down and he caught up to his own bullets, and one of the bullets went into the engine. So technically, pilot shot himself with a machine gun. Isn't that interesting? And I don't know what this one is, Grumman Kruger. Don't know anything special about it, but it's got the same tip to refuel it. So you could see all the plane. So do you know what that big thing on top of the plane is?
What?
Why did it grow this weird thing? Ah, mom's right, that's a radar. So what this plane does, is it flies in the battlefield, right? It flies, not battlefield, but it flies with other planes. But because, listen, you guys listening? It's got a radar. But because it is higher, it is able to cover more area with the radar, because the ground radar can only see, cannot see past curvature of the Earth, right? The Earth is round. So if you take your radar and get it up higher, you can see more. And so what it does, it can relay information to other planes, and, well, I don't know if it does, but it can see more stuff, see what's going on. And it's like a propeller for some reason, but it doesn't need to be fast. It just needs to go up so you could see what's going on.
It's Enterprise One. It's
22.
Yeah, these, I don't know anything about it.
This guy's got a ceiling of
35. Yeah, it doesn't fly too high. This one would be even less.
Yeah, that thing is like almost that thing looks like a decoration.
Yeah, this got a bomb on it.
Where? Oh wait, this actually has got the 48.
Yeah, you see this one's got a
48. The 48.
It's got a bomb on the bottom.
Yeah, that's actually higher than that. This is actually, yeah, 48.
All right. Yeah, it's got multiple bombs it can drop. You see bombs, Dennis?
Yeah. Two.
28 and a half.
There are three on the other side too.
Yeah, there's another one. Go up to the,
all right, so we got here all kinds of. So we got a tower up there. This is where they control landing and takeoff. We got radars and all kinds of fun stuff up there. Yeah, I guess that's also a tower. I don't know which one is which. That looks like more important tower than that tower. I don't know. All right, let's see where else we can go. I think we can go up somewhere inside the island. Yes, we can go in here. Where it says do not enter? Yes, we can go in there where it says do not enter. Go in here where there are footprints. And we're gonna go inside the island.
Yeah. Gotta admit, I hate wearing a
face. Me too. You buy a tower radar. I'm getting used to it.
Okay, Tanya, stay with everyone.
You can't go there.
Let's go in here. Intrepid Island. Ooh. Okay, inside the real ship. Okay, let's go.
Yeah.
Come on, Andrew. This is really steep. Yeah, all the stairs, everything's really steep.
This
is honestly a little bit scary, just to be honest, a little bit.
Well.
To be honest, I feel like I'm getting up to flight. To be honest, that's what I'm
Okay, wait, Andrew. Stop.
Okay, I'm lost.
So now, this is where officer's cabin, right? This is like a fancy accommodation.
Yeah, I think I saw somebody walking around over there.
And here. Yeah, this is like an office and stuff.
Alright.
Emergency exit. Okay, keep going. Continue to navigation bridge. Okay, can go up here. And you see how everything is created? That all the doors, stop. You see how all the doors, they can close and seal off one section from another. So if there is a fire or water, you can close it. And you can completely seal each section.
Why don't you go up there?
I don't know.
Yeah. How do we get to the
chart? This is a chart house where they figure out all the maps. This is a sanitize your hands where sailors sanitize their hands after shooting an enemy.
Oh, that's a dirty job.
Yeah. And that's how they can talk to one another. I guess this is for listening. Just, I don't know. But this is all very, very old.
World War II.
Yeah. Yeah,
Captain's,
wait, this was
cabin.
Used during World War II? Looks like a German helmet.
Andrew,
over here.
Here.
Looks like I found a fuse box.
Yeah, we found a fuse panel. Don't pop your fingers in there.
Damn.
Yes, Dennis.
I think I saw a German helmet.
Well, The thing about German helmets is they're very popular and they're really good designs. So all the modern helmet designs are based on German helmets.
That's the helm. Yeah, the helm.
That's the helm. This is where, Dennis, where you can steer the ship, right?
Steer the ship.
Yep.
Don't touch it. Only because of COVID.
Yes.
Normally I would say, hey.
Otherwise we can go for a loop around Manhattan.
Absolutely.
All right. It's the COVID, you know. All right. Yeah. Let's keep going this way.
Yeah.
Oops.
Man, I feel lost on
the track. So this way, stop the engine. This is where it can help, you know, this is when you're parking, you know, you're sitting there like, beep, beep, okay, are we good? Okay, parked. And this is a compass, don't touch compass.
Yeah, it's a real big compass.
Also, yeah, we shouldn't be touching things.
Yeah.
What is that hanging over there?
Oh, this is probably one of those space program capsules. That's how they rescue recover it from the water.
That's space rescue capsule.
Yes. Got a bell of some sort.
Bell type 1CB.
Okay.
S4.
All right, and that's
so you could. Oh, hey, I found a gas pump. What?
That's a radar. And it tells you.
I found the compass.
So this is what radar looks like. You see, it scans. You know that thing above that turns around. So it scans, and a dot is when it finds something. See, it has a blip. Okay, so there is an object to our right over there. This is a simulated one, but you could see right there.
Where? It disappeared.
Do you know what it means when the handles like this are wrapped?
No.
So whenever handrails or handles or anything is wrapped, that's only for like a high-level officer. So you know, normal sailors cannot go in there.
Did they actually have electronics, like all these TVs, or do them are modern?
Maybe some of them, I don't know.
Did they actually have TVs?
All right, and we're out of the control area. Okay, how is the stairs? Kind of narrow?
That's really
whoa. And I guess during like a battle they covered this. They flipped this up and they covered it so that there's only a little hole so that like
why would they do that? It's inside of
so that the bullets and stuff don't fly inside.
Bullets,
shrapnel, yeah, like this. You see how they covered it up? So you only see like a little bit. It protects windows and protects people inside.
What was here?
Look at that.
Okay.
This looks interesting. Whoa, look at those red lights.
Okay, walk slowly. Dennis. There is another radar over here. So this is where the radar operator is. There you go. That's where the enemy is coming. So now he's going to relay that information to others.
Yeah.
Dennis, do not run away. Stay with everyone.
That kind of got me into the army spirit a bit.
Yeah, right. And now we're done with tour of the island. Dennis, did you like the island and seeing all the stuff inside?
Yes.
Yeah,
you
that's
realize
pretty cool.
That this island is called Intrepid?
No, the ship is called Intrepid, but this is called an island because it's like an island in the middle of a runway. This is where planes used to land and such and take off. All right, this is a space shuttle pavilion. Let's go check it out. Come on, Dennis.
We got this one.
Yeah. Look at that.
Michelin tires.
These are the tiles that that fell off, right?
I could look at those gems.
Yeah, but they're probably not real.
Those are the ones, right?
They're yeah, but they're not the these. But yes, but these are not the real ones. Yeah.
These are some enormous jacks.
Whoa.
It is a 20-ton jack. It is a it's no longer a military, but it feels like
found the cafeteria. We walked past kitchen before, a galley, all kinds of stuff here. So we've been just exploring. This is actually not bad, not a lot of people. All right, look at this.
I want food.
Do you now? I'm surprised.
Well, I mean, like, it's just that I want to get
mom catching up. Yes. All right, I think we've seen pretty much everything that's publicly accessible. We even found one of the doors open that probably wasn't meant to be publicly accessible. Ooh, that's the workshop where they got all the tools, wrenches,
Rusty's,
all kinds of stuff. But I think we're going to go and exit over here. Okay, exit. Yay, we're exiting. Wow. All right, well, that's that was fun. Look at this giant thing. You had fun? Thanks. All right. All right, Tanya wanted to go see Concord, see in the inside. So let's go check it out. The entrance is gonna be, I don't know where. So let's go see if we can take a peek inside. This looks like it isn't open at the moment. All right, well, we can enjoy the shade underneath.
Yeah.
That's really funny to have like a little cafe. It's a beautiful place. Well, you can't go inside. That's not fair.
Yeah, I don't think we can. All right, then.
It didn't open it.
Well, if we can go inside, let's move on to our next destination. These things are insane. Do you see how all the knots, like, they're tied? There's like a wire. Yeah. It's tying different knots. That's for like extra safety. There's like a special process
how
you need to tie them and such. The submarine is closed. Concorde is closed. Everything's closed. So I guess we're done for the day. So we're just gonna walk around Manhattan and
we can go here.
Yeah, this is a wait, they wanted to see a museum store. They wanted to see the gift shop.
Oh, I saw that kind.
All right. We're gonna look around the gift shop. I have to tell kids no, we can't buy anything, and we're gonna get out of here. No, we're not buying anything here. It's all overpriced, super expensive. You can get it on Amazon at quarter of the price. These are all tourist traps.
Oh, cool.
All right, get out of here.